that bed already, darling? Yeah? Yeah. Don't come near this vlog, Mr. C, because you are naked. Are you on your first holiday? Are you on your first holiday? Yeah. Good morning from sunny Spain. We are in Mallorca. We are staying at the Tui Blue Centauri Biomar Hotel. Hi, darling. Which is also known as the Proter Resort. I think, depending on where you come from, it's different. But to us, it's a Tui resort, like the UK. So we arrived yesterday, as you may have seen, and I just did not have a chance to do a room tour. We literally threw ourselves into the room, got ready, went down to the pool, and then we literally came back, got ready within 15 minutes, and went out for tea. And then we just had a little walk around, sort of found out where things were, and then we put the kids to bed because they were absolutely knackered. Because basically, so you have them animal biscuits, then that's fine. Do you want me to open them? Yeah, so basically, we had about 45 minutes sleep on Tuesday night, and we flew at 7 o'clock on Wednesday morning. Because Indy's got a really bad cold, and she was, I think we went to bed at just after 11 and she woke up at 12, and honestly that was it. We had to then get up at 3 anyway to get ready to come here. So the kids were all knackered, and then we kind of, me and Josh were unpacking in the dark, but I'm just going to say it's a mess already because we are a family of four and that's just how it is. But I thought I'd just do a quick room tour. Of just how it's laid out, because I know there's a lot of bad reviews about this resort, and I think it's because it's classed as a 5-star, but a lot of people think it's a 4-star. I'm not really bothered about stuff like that. Like, as long as it's nice, I'm not going to complain that, oh, it's not a 5-star, it's definitely a 4-star. Are you staying with mummy, darling? So yeah, I'll just do a quick room tour. Josh is out running, that's why I am on my own. But we have got, so this is one of the suites with the rooftop pool. I'm quickly just going to refilm this room tour because it was very, very messy when I showed you before. And it just looks a lot cleaner now. So I'm just going to show you around quickly while it's cleaner. But this is the door to get in. Got a nice mirror here. Then this is like a living room area, but the sofa bed. So when I showed you earlier, this was made out into a bed, but we've asked them to put it back in. So this is where Casper slept last night. And then there's just this little unit here with a TV, like nice kettle and coffee cups. We've turned this into a bit of our milk slash food station as well. So we've got like Indy's milk and everything, and food and pouches. Then there's a little mini bar in here. When I say mini, it literally is mini, but everything is included. I'm just going to have some more of that. Actually this morning, and then this obviously is just glasses and stuff. That is the staircase out to the rooftop pool, which I will take you up later. Then you walk through these double doors, so these are sliding doors. So we did shut Casper in here last night, bless him. We've got Indy's cot, which is a nice big size travel cot, and she slept till 5:30 this morning. And then we've got our big double bed. I guess it's kind of like two small doubles together. Little bench. It's quite a lot of floor space. Then we've got this wardrobe here. Obviously, it's not really tidy because we've got two kids. And then there's just this desk and another TV. The TV does have a few English channels, but not absolutely loads. And then this is the doors to the balcony, which I did show you in my last little room tour that I did. But I'll just, like, literally that's the balcony. It's a nice big balcony, nice chairs, nice little table. And then this is the view. So this is one of the pools. We was in this one yesterday, but it's really, really cold. And then you can see, like, there's like a kid's one. It's got like a little slide and some stuff in. But yeah, the pool is freezing here. That's why it's so empty. But I don't understand why it's so cold. There's a pool around this corner, which has got like a swim-up bar and stuff, which is where everyone seems to be. But I don't understand why it's so much warmer. I think it must be heated compared to this one. I literally feel like I'm walking around with a glass of wine. A bloody bottle of wine, should I say. Oh, It's fizzing. And then this is the door to the bathroom, which I'm not going to go in because Casper's in there, so I'll add the one from the last. Inside, I'll quickly show you the bathroom. Really, really nice size, especially for a family. So we've got the nice big bath. Casper thinks this is a slide. And then we've got two sinks, huge big mirror, just put my mum to my way, got a nice shower, and then we've got a separate toilet and, what do you call that, BD. Casper's just been playing with the phone in here. And again, this bathroom's really messy. I've been having to wash bottles. I had to ask the bar staff for some fairy liquid because we could not find the supermarket anywhere. There's loads of shops around here, but they're all for like tit and tat and seaside stuff. So yeah, I wish it was a little bit tidier. I should have done it yesterday, but I didn't. I look like I've got a bottle of wine in my hand, but it's sparkling water. But yeah, this is the room. So we're on full day number one today. I'm gonna try and vlog as much as possible. As soon as Josh gets back, I will just show you the rooftop pool as well, so he can just quickly watch the kids. But I'm just going to start getting dressed now and get ready for breakfast because I'm hoping that he's back soon. Right, I'm just going to show you outside now. Josh is back. This is a really tough door, which I'm glad, because obviously Casper's sleeping in there on his own. So these are this. Obviously, it's not the safest thing for children. It was a bit scary carrying Indy down here yesterday. They obviously can't fall through or anything, but he's just actually falling down. But I feel like when you're taller, it looks worse than what it is, whereas Casper's a lot closer to the ground. Then that's obviously where our friends come up. So that goes down to their balcony. And then, yeah, this is the rooftop pool. So we've got some sun loungers here with like canopies, and then this is our private pool. So we share this with two other rooms. So we've obviously got ours and our friends here, and then there's two more there which will share this. So obviously they're like our sun loungers there. And then them sun loungers under them canopies are for other people who will share this room with us. But yeah, this is our rooftop pool, private pool. I've not actually checked the temperature. It's warm. So the pool down there is freezing. So I think today I literally might suggest just coming up here, because obviously it's a lot warmer than down there. But how cool is this? We've got our own pool. And then obviously this is just whack overlooking the rest of the resort. It's weird because I feel like even though we've got our own private pool, I don't feel like we'll actually spend that much time up here. We were gonna do like put the kids to bed and come up here on a night, but I don't think we'll be doing that. I think it's just too far away, even though like obviously no one can get into the rooms. It's just not, we're just not going to do that. And then because obviously there's a pool downstairs, well, there's two pools downstairs and obviously the kids pool, even though it's really really cold, I just feel like we probably won't come up here that much. But I might just suggest coming up here like in an afternoon after we've had dinner, because it's really warm, the water. Or maybe even coming here in the morning, because honestly this water is actually warm. Like I would fully get in there. We put Indy in the pool yesterday and she absolutely screamed her little head off because it was so cold. So she literally has not been in the water yet. So I think the only way I'll get her in is by bringing her in this one.
Wash all this kit. Take down crack look.
The bees is loving life.
It's the spot for the college bottle, is that? Yeah, then we. Annie Jack, you can go in chat.
Day number two, evening, and I'm literally just running a bath for Indy B. I think I'm actually going to get in it myself as well, because we don't obviously have a seat or anything for her, and it is quite deep. I feel like I'd really hurt my arms if I leant over. We're getting ready to go out this evening, so instead of me having a shower, I just think I might as well get in the bath with her. And then Josh and Casper are still up on the rooftop pool, which is... Yeah, Josh and Casper are still on the rooftop pool, so they're going to come down in 5 minutes, because I said I'd bath Indy first and then Casper can get in that water, because I feel like he would just splash her really badly because she's got no seat or anything. So I'm just going to jump in with her, I think, and then get ready to go out for this evening. Day number three, Mr. C. We're just going on a little walk this morning, aren't we? Just have a look at the hotel lob. Then show you the outside, because it's actually very, very nice. What did you have for breakfast, Mr. C? You lost your tongue. No, that's not a swimming pool, darling. That's a little pond, isn't it? She said they're waiting downstairs for us, but...
Stop.
Are you laughing? Are you stuck? Do you need a push?
I think it's stuck in the ditch.
Woo! Wow, look at you, Mr. Dude. Pull, I've got him, don't worry. So we've just found out that we can come into this free splash park slash kind of entertainment park, and there's these little cars and there's a few little machines and then some trampolines, like go-karts. Obviously we have to pay for them, but like we're allowed in here for free, and then the splash park's completely free. We just came to walk this morning and realized that it's all included in like this whole resort. So we didn't realize, but we're kind of staying in like a huge resort, and there's like 6 hotels, but each hotel's really big, so you don't like eat out of that hotel, if that makes sense. But then there's this all for free, which is just great for the kids especially. And it's a good job we're only on day two, because we've got, what day is it today? We've got Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday left. So we've got, how many days is that? 5 days left. So yeah, once we've been in this, we're just then going to go into the free splash park, although we've not brought any towels, but we've all got our swim stuff on. So that's really good to know. I'm glad that we've managed to find this out, because what a shame it would have been to not. I am currently just walking around looking for Poe, because we've lost him. It's literally about 2 minutes after I last filmed them clips, and Casper said to me, where's Poe gone? And I've got no idea. So I'm hoping that if I retrace my steps... Oh, Josh is ringing me. Hello? Hiya. You what? You've got Poe. All right. Dad's got Poe.
What's that then? You know how it looks? Tell me it just sways. I couldn't have that. I'm going to push it side to side, you know?
He's still sleeping, darling.
Darling Jack's asleep.
Ugh. I think she's tired.
Careful, but Casper. Thank you.
Day number three completed. Isn't it in the bee? It's nearly 5 o'clock. It's 10 to 5 and we've decided tonight that we are having an early tea and getting the kids to bed, and then we're just going to sit on the balconies and just play cards and drink, because last night they were all so grumpy. One of them fell off the stage and hit the head and got like a massive lump, like it was such bad swelling. By the time he'd gone to bed, his mum fell asleep, half any sofa fell asleep with him. So we just all, well, me, Josh and Nate played cards on the balcony. And Sophie was in bed, so tonight we've decided we're literally having tea at 6, coming in at like 7:30, getting the kids to bed and then chilling on the balcony, because our balconies are right next door to each other. Obviously our rooms are next door to each other, and we're just going to leave the patio doors open and sit on the balconies, and we can go downstairs and get some drinks and stuff, and we can bring them all up on a tray. So look how cool my indie bee looks. You'll just be such a little poppy, aren't you? Are you my little poppy? We've literally just been swimming all day. So this morning we just went on the walk that nature is ow to the entertainment place and the kids' water park. We decided not to stay there because we didn't have towels or anything, so we're going to go there tomorrow. But we've been in the big pool this morning, which is a lot warmer. I think it's the only heated pool there is. There's two pools. The one that we were at on the first day is absolutely freezing. But, like, the main one, which is around, like, all the reception area and stuff, is warm, so I think it must be heated. So we were in that this morning, then we had some lunch, and then we've just been on the rooftop all afternoon because the kids were asleep. Josh was downstairs doing some work on the balcony while our two were asleep, and so I had a nice hour upstairs chilling. But yeah, we're just going to go get ready for some tea now. I'm going to put Indy down for sleep for hopefully 20-30. You are so beautiful! Hopefully for like 20-30 minutes, because she's not slept since. But she woke up at 2:30 and it's nearly 5 o'clock. She's definitely not going to last till 7:30-ish. But yeah, I'm going to get ready to go for tea and just have a more of a chilled getting ready stage, because we've just been rushing around like crazy, haven't we, the last few times. You are such a gorgeous chicken. You are gorgeous chicken. We all ready to go?
Yeah.
Out for dinner? Yeah.
Yeah, mister.
Daddy and Casper matching. Yeah, she's still going to be wet, isn't she?
Can we just dry your hair a bit with that?
Not great lighting at all. It's but yeah, I'm going out with wet hair tonight. Very blunt. Wet haircut. I don't have any, like, thick hair oil though, so it's not really staying back, and I don't have any hairspray, but oh well. We're not going out for very long tonight, like I said, we're just going to come back early. So I've just got denim shorts on, a little vest and a long shirt, and I've just done my makeup very sun-kissed. I'm not really sure about my hair, to be honest, but I'm just going to let it dry and see what happens.
Combine harvester's cutting it.
What's the combine harvester cutting?
Birdie.
He's cutting the birdie. That's not very nice.
There's another one in front. Look. Look.
Good morning. We are on a morning walk. Josh was meant to get up and go running, and Casper woke up as his room is near the front door and he just decided not to. But then I heard Casper talking, didn't realise Josh hadn't gone, so I got up anyway, and then Indy got up for a feed. It was about 6:30, 6:45. And then we've just decided to come out on a nice morning walk instead, because I was going to go to the gym this morning anyway. I've not done any exercise really since we got here. I've obviously walked. I think on the day that we got here, Nate said on his watch he'd done like 13,000 steps. I think we actually did a lot of steps in the airports and stuff. But yeah, we're just on a nice morning walk. I don't know where we're going to go. We've got this sort of cycle path which is right in front of our hotel. So that's our hotel there. And then we've got this nice cycle path So that's the park there that you can see out of our bedroom window. So we are literally, so that up there with the blue towels there, that is our rooftop pool. And this bar last night, Delaney's, had some sort of karaoke night on because wow, it was so loud. Delaney's United Taste of America, it's called. But yeah, we're just out on a nice little walk. I don't know where we're going. I don't know where this path leads. We've walked the other way. So we've walked down there towards the beach. Me and Sophie did that the other day, but I don't know where this one goes. But we're just exploring the area. See what we can find. So we're just on a cycle tuk-tuk. Not sure it's the safest thing in the world, to be honest, with the baby. But here we are. I don't think we're going this way. We can't go. We need to go down there.
Sure.
Well, yeah, where are you going to go here? The road end, unless you can fit down there. Oh my god. Oh my god. No, it says no bike, no bike, no bike. No bike. Good afternoon. I'm just coming up to the rooftop pool on my own. How peaceful. So the kids are both asleep in the prams downstairs. And I am just coming to do a spot of sunbathing. I'm not sure how long Casper will stay asleep because he really needs a wee and he's just refusing to have one. You can tell he's really uncomfortable. He's like sleeping on his side in the pram. But Indy should do about 2 hours, but obviously it depends if Casper wakes her up or not. Josh is about to go running. But they are obviously literally at the bottom of them stairs. And the do not disturb signs on and the no cleaning signs, so no one should walk in, and I'm gonna have to go and check on them like every 5 minutes. But I will be able to hear them if they start crying. But yeah, they're literally like at the bottom of there. But this is my only sort of time to chill really, because Josh goes running every day because he's got a marathon when we get home. We get home next Wednesday and his marathon's on the Sunday, so he does actually need to go running. And he didn't go this morning. That's why he obviously went on that walk instead. So yeah, him and Nate are going running, then Sophie, I'm sure, will be up here soon when her kids are asleep. I don't think they're quite asleep yet. And then we'll both between us just keep going down and checking on either of them. I might get half an hour up here, I might get 10 minutes, I might get an hour, who knows. You're very noisy, darling. Come on, mister. What have you just been on today with daddy?
I've been on motorbike.
You've been on a big bike? And you've now got a tattoo arm like daddy's.
Look at
your arm, you're the one. Wow. We need to wash that off, don't we? It like a tattoo, like daddy. Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on then.
Right, come on then. Into the hotel. Come on this way. What? Up here. So I think we're on day number 5 now. And it's about 2:30 in the afternoon, 3 o'clock. And I am just on my own. I've come to, I was basically gonna go sit in a coffee shop and have a coffee, but it's literally just closing as I got there, so I've turned around to go the other way. But I think all that's the other way, because there's more this way, is actual bars. So I'm just gonna see if the one that I know of serves coffee. Just needed 30 to 45 minutes piece. I was just gonna edit a few videos for TikTok and reels, and I've got some content to submit as well, so I just kind of need a break because Josh has gone to the gym every single morning for a good hour and a half, an hour, and as soon as he's left the kids have woken up, so I've been on my own with them every day for like an hour and a half, and I just needed that break. My friend Sophie's asleep because her little boy sleeps like 2.5 hours in the day and she just sleeps with him, but I can't do that. I would rather just be awake and be on my own and chill. Hey. Hiya, darling. When did you wake up?
Diesel woke up about half an hour ago.
As you have just seen, Casper has just been on a motorbike, electric motorbike. Well, he's actually still on it now. I was gonna explain it when we was down there, but he nearly crashed it quite a few times and it was just a little bit scary. Then we stopped at the park and Indy did a massive poo. So I just said I'm gonna come back to the hotel because it's only literally like down there, so we were near anyway. But Josh said he was taking it. Wow, that's very. Josh said he was taking it back to swap it for something that he could drive, because the hire is for an hour and we were literally on it for like 15 minutes. The first 5 minutes of him being on it, he was not looking where he was going. He had the foot on the pedal. He was crashing into walls. He crashed into a tree, and Josh was like, "This is going back." But he eventually did actually get the hang of it, and he was doing all right, to be fair. But yeah, they're down there. I've literally just changed Indy's bum and I've just been in the shower trying to see if she'll go to sleep, but I don't think it's happening anytime soon, to be honest. She just keeps trying to crawl in here, but I know she's really tired. She's not slept since maybe 2:30, and it's nearly 5:30. In fact, I think it's about 5:45. So we've got dinner tonight in the Asian restaurant in the hotel, which is the first booking that we've had all holiday. We literally go home on Wednesday and it's Monday evening. But when you've got 4 kids on the holiday, obviously booking some of the restaurants is not on your top priorities at all. I think it was Saturday night. Every single kid in the restaurant was absolutely on one. There were screaming children everywhere. So I don't know how tonight is going to go at all, but our booking's at 7. We've usually been going down for dinner at like 6:15, eating in the having a drink in the piano bar, which is next door, and then going into the all-inclusive restaurant because that doesn't open till 6:30. But tonight we're not eating till 7. So it will be interesting to see how it goes. Casper's not had a nap since this morning. He slept at the water park for about an hour, but that's it. He's not slept since, so fingers crossed he'll be all right. And if Indy doesn't sleep now, then fingers crossed she sleeps when we get there. Don't crush her into that wall. Is it breakfast time, darling? Is it breakfast time?
You say sorry to Nora, mister, please.
Oh, no, it's a pond, isn't it?
It's a pond,
yeah.
Yeah.
It's our last day today, and we go home tomorrow morning, and we are just chilling on the rooftop pool this morning. Indy's asleep in her cot and
I've literally just got upstairs.
And Mr. T is just waiting on Daddy getting some more cream, sun cream. And then I think we're going to go in the water, although I've got a feeling it's going to be really cold. We've not been up here since, I don't think we've ever been in this in the morning. We've always been downstairs in the heated pool. So it's probably going to be quite cold. But we've had a very good time. Obviously, it's just been the normal sort of holiday of Madrid with kids. Well, we'll find it's over there, look. Right over there on them benches. Look, come here. Watch where Mummy's pointing. Right at the other side, under the sheds. Can you see it on that chair? Yeah. But it is great being up here because he can kind of just run around and we're not really scared of where he's going because we can just see him at all times. Whereas when you're down by the other pools, obviously they just blended in with so many other kids, so it's a bit scarier. But yeah, we've had a good time. We've had a lot of tantrums in the restaurant. Not tantrums, just kind of like kicking off and screaming from all kids. Everyone's kids on this holiday. But other than that, it has been a pretty good holiday. Here he comes.
Hola, senor, senorita.
The Adonis.
The sun's going to blow the leaves.
You're blowing the leaves?
Leaf blowing noodle.
Go on then. You blow them leaves. That's one way to break it, bud.
Let's get out of the bush.
Guess waiting with noodle.
Oh. There, you gonna jump in with me?
Yeah.
No! Why are you jumping with me? Towel on.
Right. Who's that? Who's that? I'm trying to get to it. Last day, and I am literally just sat on the rooftop with Indy B while Caspian is asleep under them towels. Josh went to the gym about an hour ago, even longer than that, actually. And Indy was asleep in her cot downstairs and Casper fell asleep there, so I was just sat here because the stairs are literally just there and I could hear her. But after about 20 minutes she started crying, so here we are.
Oh no!
I think she's teething, to be honest. She's got a really snotty nose and she's been chewing a dummy. She's hardly slept and she's got loads of gunge coming out of her ear. Which I know it's not an ear infection because she's actually had it for about 10 weeks on and off, and we've had two courses of antibiotics and it's not done anything. So I do actually think it's when she's teething. She's got her two bottom teeth and I think she's getting the other two at the side now because the top teeth don't look like they're coming through yet at all. So I think it's the four bottom ones that are going to come through first. So we're just waiting for Josh to come back. Hopefully he'll be back anytime soon. And then I'm going to get ready and meet... Oh, you're having that, are you? And meet Sophie for a drink downstairs at like 6 o'clock before we go for dinner. Dinner doesn't open till 6. Last night we went to an Asian restaurant. It was one of the restaurants in the hotel. I think I did actually speak about it. And it was the worst decision we ever made. All the kids were playing up and there was couples in there on their own and it was just horrific. So we just it as quickly as possible and actually left as quickly as possible. But yeah, I can't exactly go downstairs and start getting ready because Casper's up here on his own. And there's obviously a pool and stuff up here, so I can't leave him even though he's fast asleep. Oh dear, darling! So tonight is our last night and we do actually leave early in the morning. I think we're getting picked up at 8:30, but it's not too bad. But we need to definitely pack tonight and stuff. Wow.
Hi, darling.
Hiya. We're about to board the plane, aren't we?
Yeah. Look how dead it is. I can't actually believe how quiet it is. We've had a good holiday.
We had a good holiday. Yeah.